Oh well, as long as it doesn't have kind of power into it, I think that's better. Wait, I have to do all these rooms again. Oh, fuck. Ah, I guess I have to be invisible.
I guess I can do alignment, which is the point of Pierce.
Oh, look, it worked. If the city is deserted, why is there this force field? And I'm so going to tell you, when I have a choice of which rune I insert, I'm going to check it and look after it in a walkthrough, because no, I was going to fuck this up somehow. No. This game is taking way too long as it is. Okay, walkthrough time, we're back. Okay, yes. Area, item, self, creature. Yes, we actually have to summon the guardian that's opposing Pierce's alignment, so the red one. And because this game is being a dick, I have to do this again with all the towers, recasting the shield magic every time because of the damage shield, and of course lots and lots of small annoying creatures that teleport me into their fucking dimension. What is this? What is this obelisk doing there? I can't cast anything in here. Oh, sure. Okay, that was a nice one. I was wondering what was this corpse doing there. Oh, these are the things I sent into the Trapper dimension. Okay, that's a nice touch, game. I have to admit this. So, I hope I cleared it out. I think I should do this now every time. I just enter a room and cast a damage spell. Just kill everything. Yeah, why not? It's working. Okay, let's run back. How about you catch some bus? Okay. I'm just wondering, why am I summoning another ancient god in this? Okay, it's opposing Pius Antonius, but I still don't get it. It's still an ancient dark god. Summoning an ancient dark god into this world is really a smart idea. Even if it fights another one, one of them will win, and the winner will be trying to take over us. My opinion. I don't know. Power. Oh, I have to summon some stuff now. Okay. A blue trapper. Fine. Spellus, summon trapper, blue. Oh, these were the creatures that were removed when I entered this. Lumbering. The metal plague is mounted on the monolith. It depicts a silhouette of a lumbering corpse, a zombie, a wet one. Well, you want a wet zombie? You get a wet zombie. Stay there for all eternity, you sucker. I'm honest. This game is okay, yes. Oh wait, what color? Green. Let's look at it, like. Attached to the monitor is of horror. Okay. This game is okay, yes, it's fine. I can't really say much about it, against it. The riddles are a bit stupid and long drawn out, but so were the ones to Resident Evil. But I do kinda have to say, in my opinion, it's not scary. Some people place this game very, very high on the top 10 scariest games, and I don't think it's scary, because as soon as you can cast magic, you're practically invincible. Yes, I know what you're going to say, you died a few times in the net. Remember, let's playing and replaying, there is a difference. Sure, I could be like every 10 seconds, oh, I'm going to refill my mana, be right back, or I'm just letting you showing you how I refill my mana. That would be no fun. I usually only did this when I really had to, like there was no other chance. But other than that, as soon as you have magic, you are invincible. So, and being invincible kinda defeats the purpose of a horror game. Not to mention, the enemies aren't really that threatening. Just I don't know, compared to Resident Evil, those powers, no powers. There are some pretty, you can run out of ammunition if you're not careful. You have to evade lots of zombies. The zombies can actually kick your ass if you're not careful. Power. They can overwhelm you because there's so many. Here, if this game didn't have the sanity meter, it would be really, really boring. Even though the sanity meter didn't really do a lot, too. Do I have to fight you now? Hello? Oh, she doesn't have a drinking bottle like grandfather. Hello? Can I get out of this? Hello? Yeah, and sometimes these scary parts are just annoying. And those insanity things are just annoying. Told you this isn't really happening. Okay, I'm not allowed to go in the middle. Okay, understood. And I still think this game is way too long drawn out. Considering there isn't really that much happening, and story-wise, there's not much story. It's all about, yeah, well, this. Your uncle died, and now you explore these. Oh, what the fuck do I have to do? And of course, then there's things like this where you just don't know what to do, and will most likely just try an error, be right back. there's a strange worm-like thing. What do I have to do? Let's see. Ruins of anger. The equation is whenever with the summoning spells. Yes, I already did this. Okay. I did this. This is a very crafty puzzle. It took me quite a while to figure out how to play through this game the first time. This large rectangular room has a giant pit in the center, surrounded by a giant glowing purple pattern on the ground. Alex can only walk in the pattern. This is the only way she can get around the pit in the center. If Alex walks into this purple center, a huge red worm, just like the one supposed to Bert and Michael saw in the chapters, will storm out of the pit, scaring Alex to death. While she doesn't actually die, the worm doesn't take up any health at all, she will just lose 3/4 of her sanity. However, making Alex go partly insane, she will begin to hallucinate. The classic sepia tone color pattern went all through the room, Rex experienced something like this as it Edwards as one chapter. There are two ways to get out of the sepia tone sanity effect. You can either wait for Alex to regain her head, or you can cast the pure recover sanity spots in her, which will get rid of these effects immediately. This will place her back in the same spot as So if Alex cannot walk across the purple thing on the ground, how the hell will she be able to get through the room? It's actually very simple. Alex will be able to walk anywhere on the floor. However, she must be sneaking around. This is something that you probably haven't done very often, with exceptions for avoiding trappers in Anthony's chapter. Before walking, the purple part of the floor, press and hold down the X button to have Alex walk very slowly, despite how hard you're pushing control stick. While sneaking around over the room, you do get through the door leads out of her. I would have said, oh, I have to sneak here. Oh boy, I hate it. Sneak. Ooh, there's a giant purple worm, just sneak around it. Ugh. It's not like, wait, I can understand if you can actually hear her, but come on. Oh well, I'm done soon. Soon I'm done with this game. What was I saying? Yes, like I said, the puzzles are really annoying. Really annoying against Chaturanga. Really, really annoying, and it's old. Like I said, it's not a bad game per se. It is unique with the sanity effect and stuff, but they could have made it better. This is one of the few games where actually cutting down about 1/4 of the game may have helped the game. Seriously. Make more interesting enemies, enhance the combat is horrible. Seriously, the combat is just, I stick my sword into you until you fall over and die. That's the combat in this game. It's... Sure, you can argue that the Resident Evil combat isn't that thrilling either, but in Resident Evil you didn't have to do that much combat. And shooting a zombie in the head is kinda enjoyable, but going toe-to-toe with them all the time is kinda annoying. And the best thing in Resident Evil